Okay, today I'm going to start a little bit early. Starting with problems already. So we're going to do Kelowna. I don't know if I'm not right, but no one's here to correct me, so it's quite close enough. To Toronto. It's going to be a lot longer flight, 1,700 nautical miles. So more chances of failures, because why not? Because I really, really want a engine fire. So normally I'm kind of watching the stream with my Microsoft Surface, but my Surface will not turn on. So I have no way of monitoring my stream other than using my cell phone. So that'll be fun. At least my cell phone's fully charged. All right, I guess we'll get started with this mistake. Get ground power. I'll go ahead and seat belts and no smoking because you guys suck. Okay, I guess that doesn't turn on when the ground power's on. Good to know. Alright. Oh, we gotta align IRS, don't we? We need that. Okay, first things first. I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna have enough fuel. So let's give me some fuel. 47%, that's not enough. So I will need... Actually, wasn't there... Ground services. Isn't there a thing to request fuel? Yeah, fuel truck, there we go. 25... Shit, how many pounds do I need? Let's say... 3,000? You son of a bitch. 30,000 pounds? Right? Let's try that. Request fuel truck. Let's request maintenance since we're here. That's waiting. Let's do payload. Let's see what. We'll wait for the fuel thing to finish, and then I'll just unload some crap if I have to. This maintenance truck. Oh, there it is. Okay, let's start fueling. Okay, while we're fueling, let's go ahead and do my IRS crap. I guess that's correct. We are at CYLW. I know we're at gate 4, but that's close enough. Okay, I'm gonna switch to ATS 127.5. Okay, now we're gonna do our airport, so we're gonna do ground 121 700.
Kelowna ground BB Seal Plover 6-9er heavy ready to copy IFR clearance to Toronto.
BB Seal Plover 6-9er heavy is cleared to Toronto Airport as filed. Take off runway 34 climb and maintain 6,000 feet. Departure frequency is 133.5 squawk 6665.
Bravo, yes.
BB Seal Plover 6-9er heavy cleared to Toronto Airport as filed. Take off runway 34 climb and maintain 6,000 feet. Departure on 133.5 squawk 6665.
BB Seal Plover 6-9er heavy read back, correct. Contact ground on 121.7. Good day.
Okay, so we'll do, probably do this, departure, and it's going to be in B1, transition, let me guess. We're going to be 33 right. Number 6. And I think that's sweet. Oh, yep, that's it. And that one. Let's execute. Okay, I know that. I see that. We'll fix that in a minute. Flight level is 33, so we'll do. Gonna set that now. Good, that looks good. So our fuel is 30. So what about, what does this say our arrival is going to be at? Let's find out. Oops. Fuel, that's, so 4.6 tons, is that enough fuel? Let's add some more fuel. Let's do 30. Let's do that. Let's add 300 more pounds. Or at least the maintenance van. We don't need them anymore because I'm assuming that means maintenance was done. Hey, that's 301. I said 300. Oh, close enough. 4.9. That should be good enough. Okay, now my weight. I should check. I am gonna cheat for this. That's not the button I wanted. Oh, actually, that's okay. Still at 100. Yeah, so we're still good. We're still good. So I'm assuming that's going to be enough fuel to get there. 4.9. That's making it even 5, just in case. Let's do 30. 600. Okay, it's gonna be close enough. I released the fuel truck, I don't need him anymore. So 5.2, perfect, okay. Good. As I change my weights and crap. Okay, so I guess we're good. I think it's time to get some alcohol and start the party. Make sure my camera's still working. Good, it's still working. Alright, yep, let's start the party. I'm gonna get some alcohol. Oh, APU first and then alcohol. Alcoholism.
Testing GWPS and TCAS.
TCAS test pass.
Glide slope. Pull up. Wind shear. Wind shear. Wind shear. Terrain, terrain, pull up.
Airspeed, low.
Kelowna ground, Jazz 839er, tree taxi, to the gate.
Sink rate.
Jazz 839er, tree taxi, to
terrain.
Gate 6, via taxiway
pull
echo.
Up. Don't sink. Don't sink. Too low, terrain. Too low, gear. Too low, flaps.
Taxiing
too low,
to gate
terrain.
6, using taxiway
wide
echo, Jazz 839er, tree.
Bank angle, bank angle.
Approaching decision height. Decision height.
2,500. 1,000. 500. 400. 300. 200. 100. 50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
Wind shear. Wind shear. Wind shear. Too low, terrain.
Oops. Buttons. All right. So here's to a successful crash. Alright. Let's press the taxi too.
Kelowna ground, BB Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy with golf ready to taxi IFR.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy taxi to and hold short of runway tree 4 using taxiway Echo Delta.
Contact tower on 119er decimal 6 when ready. Guess we should get rid of the stop that. Hey, stop that. Oops. All right. Let's see. 220. Okay, I gotta be at 220. Actually, oops.
Did you copy?
I did. It just didn't hit the button.
Taxiing hold short runway tree for using taxiway Echo Delta BB Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy.
9600. So I'll be standby for ground service. We'll go that way.
Kelowna ground, BB Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy requesting pushback.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy pushback request accepted.
Clubber 6-9 or Heavy requesting pushback tug to steer the aircraft to the right.
BB SEAL Clubber 6-9 or Heavy, your request has been transmitted to the operator.
I forgot to check previously, but the foot pedals are in fact working, so that's a bonus. Uh-oh. Oh. Dumbass. The other engine was already running.
Kelowna ground BB SEAL Clubber 6-9 or Heavy requesting the end of pushback.
BB SEAL Clubber 6-9 or Heavy request to end pushback received.
Almost forgot to turn on the fuel cutoff, so will it start? Oh, it's gonna start. Okay, good. Alright, we're gonna wait for that engine to start up. We'll turn on TCAST. Okay, close enough. So we're gonna go on engine generators. Turn on bleed air, we'll turn on APUs, or I mean packs. Turn off APUs since we're just wasting fuel. And we'll definitely need it. Alright, everything else looks good. I think everything looks good, so we'll go ahead and start going. Flaps 15. Auto throttle flight directors 1 and 2 on. Auto brake to rejected takeoff. And we're going to go ahead and arm IAS if it'll let us. Yes. And also nav if it'll let us. It will. Alright. Sexcellent. Okay, everything looks good, I guess. Oh, I forgot to turn on taxi lights, didn't I? Because, you know, that matters right now. Oops, too much brakes. Let's take a number 3.
Kelowna Tower BB SEAL Clubber 6-9 are heavy ready for departure runway 34 IFR to Toronto.
BB SEAL Clubber 6-9 are heavy altimeter 30.09 are wind 3554. Cleared for takeoff runway 34.
cleared for takeoff runway 34 BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy.
I'm gonna go ahead and do the turnaround thing. I wanted to give myself as much runway as possible. So I am gonna go to the end, do a U-turn, and come back. While we're waiting, more alcoholism. And as usual, as soon as I get a stable takeoff and stable flight, whatever, I will, of course, set my failures. Come on, turn. Oh, maybe I should turn the thing more. Dumbass. Yeah. That was my fault. My bad. Oh, I know why I was doing that. Alright. Why did you do that? Yeah, fine, I'll leave it off. Certainly is. I guess I didn't need to go that far back.
V1.
Rotate. V2. They're ready to climb.
Gear up. Up to 10. After the game freezes again, because it's doing that freezing still. Really nice. Okay, it's gauge autopilot. Do my speed.
Decimal 5 for BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy.
1335.
Vancouver Center BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy is at 3,100 feet, climbing 6,000 feet.
Oh no, not a buffet.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, Vancouver Center altimeter 30.09.
Okay, let's go to flaps 5. Actually, let's go to flaps 2. Flaps 1. What am I supposed to be at? 220, so let's go to 220. Oh, I'm at 220, never mind. Dumbass. Alright, I'm just gonna go flaps up. Okay, I'll break off. Does the freeze thing again, because not science. Looks like we're good. Alright, once it tells me to go to the next set of speeds, then I'll do my failures.
Climb and maintain 17,000 feet. Keep speed not above 220 knots. BB Seal Clubber 6.9 or heavy.
Okay, so we're gonna climb. We'll stay at 220 because we're not supposed to go faster than that. Just fine. All right, time to set up our failures. And yes. 59. No limit. Execute. So far, we're doing good. About feet, so we're going to turn off. Anyways. I'm going to leave the camera off. Nobody cares. We'll see. I'll probably tell you about me. I'm going to see if I can turn it. That was bad. Alright. Let's go to the feet now. Let's go to the feet. Sorry, it doesn't matter. It's fine. It's fine. This is fine. It's fine. We turned around. Sure, there's nothing to do. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I'm going to reach out and hear about this. Whether it's good. We're going to fuel. See. Sometimes, sometimes we're good. We're going to fuel. I don't think I have anything else to get, so that. Right? Let's go again. 5-0. I'm going to squeeze, 7 peaks. Just close. 6 peaks. You go to shortly? It's an Abby. I'm not going to start to lose the battle now. Replacement. I'm not going to try to battle. 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 That's good. Yeah, that's good. Oh, baby, simple. You can pass with it? Nice. Yeah. Okay, 10 minutes, so we should have an error very soon. I'm gonna do this. Oh, how come it's not going to... Oh. Idiot. It's supposed to go to there. Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch again. Okay, so I have one active failure, obviously. So what is that error? I don't know. Nothing appears to be... No air lights. I think we're good. Well, good enough.
Generic Tango Sierra X-ray climb and maintain flight level 410.
Well, they have one air. I'm not going to look.
Climb and maintain flight level 410. Generic Tango Sierra
78 is our speed, so we'll do that. I don't know what the error is. I mean, there's no warning lights on. So nothing. Alright, well then, whatever the error is, it doesn't matter.
Two BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy. Vancouver Center BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy is passing flight level 245, climbing flight level 250.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy.
This is terrible because now I gotta figure out a laptop solution for my other. Crap.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy climb and maintain flight level 310.
310.
Climb and maintain flight level 310 BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy contact Vancouver Center on 133.6.
I'm just gonna let it automatically do it because I don't wanna do it.
133.6 for BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy. Vancouver Center BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy is at flight level 250, climbing
so that's very
flight
nice.
Level 310.
Okay, so let's check our fuel usage. So 4.3, so we're okay, I think. Don't know what the minimum required fuel is to, you know, do stuff, but that should be fine. I'm sure that's fine. More importantly, we are above the clouds now, finally. What is a Navi? Let's see. Navi I. Oh, Ryan Naviation? Oh, nice. Let's see, we've got oil quantity 65 in the left, 70 in the right. I think VIB is vibration, I'm assuming. So The engines are currently not set in vibrated mode. No, M2FF fuel something. I don't know, who cares. Four more minutes and less than 4 minutes and I should have another error.
Decimal 75 for BV Seal Clubber 69er Heavy. Edmonton Center BV Seal Clubber 69er Heavy is passing flight level 295, climbing flight level 310.
Anything good around me? Some more mountains? Still only have one error, but we have a couple minutes left. I clicked it. Did I break it? It was fine last week. Uh-oh. Oh, there it goes. Okay. Until we get another failure. I'm still crossing my fingers and hoping for a catastrophic failure of some type. Gotta have a catastrophic failure. Ugh. 33. I'm gonna increase altitude.
Edmonton Center BV Seal Clubber 69er Heavy. Request flight level 330.
BV Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, climb and maintain flight level 330.
Climb and maintain flight level 330.
Doing what the FMC says for me to do, so I'm doing 33. Okay, I should have another error by now. Nope, not yet. So just have the one.
WestJet 461, contact Vancouver Center on 133.
There we go, there's an error message. Hydraulics. I have a hydraulic failure somewhere. Engine 1. Don't need it. Alright, let's turn that off. No big deal. Not a big deal. I have three more where that came from. I have two electric pumps, plus the engine driven on engine 2, so engine 1 is just not going to have to power hydraulic pumps. Not a problem. Oh, 9 more minutes until another error. Let's see what happens. Well, since we got 9 minutes, let's see what outside looks like. Ooh, it looks nice. Oh, I see what that guy's doing. He's going through canyons and shit. Very nice. I can see him from here. I don't think he can. Looks like he's flying above the mountains there. I thought maybe he was like carving through the canyons here or something. Maybe he is. Actually, that would probably be fun to do that in a jet, or even a propeller-driven plane. Maybe at some point I'll do that. Alright, fuck it. Let's see what the other error is. So, wait, I got two hydraulics. EMDPA hydraulic leak. Then EDP one hydraulic fail. So, oh shit. I do have hydraulic. A is 71, B is 32%. I wonder if I need that. Do I need that?
WestJet 112 descend and maintain flight level 290. 31%.
So I'm losing hydraulics in A. So the question is, if I lose in hydraulics A, does that mean
going to 133 decimal tree?
What stops working when I lose hydraulic A? That's gonna be the question. We will find out what happens when hydraulic A pumps itself dry.
Edmonton Center BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy Flight Level 330.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy Edmonton Center. Continue to tow off as planned.
Okay. So we're just gonna keep going until the plane makes me land or I land like you're supposed to land. But I don't know what happens if you lose hydraulics A. Hydraulic leaking, it's fine. What if I, no, if I gotta leave the pump on, I mean, yeah, fuck it. We'll see what happens. I don't know what's gonna happen if I lose hydraulics A.
Climb and maintain 14,000 feet.
Let's see. Let's Google it. 737 loss of
solid fluid.
Okay. Well, Google does not help. So I guess we're just gonna have to do this in real time. We'll see what happens. I don't know. I don't know what will happen when I lose all of hydraulics A. I would assume hydraulic B takes over for hydraulics A, maybe? Oh, you know what? Let's see. Hydraulic system, there we go.
Turkish 79er, contact Edmonton Center on 132.75. Good day. Edmonton Center, Pasco Tree 056, is passing 8,000.
Oh, there we go. Services supplied. System A. Autopilot A, ailerons, rudder, elevator. And elevator feel, inboard flight spoiler, ground spoilers, PTU auto slats, number one thrust reverser, nose wheel steering, alternate brakes, main only, and landing gear. I might need landing gear. Well, let's... Actually, fine. Alright, well, that's fine. Hydraulic or autopilot B should work. Oh, I'm already up to 3 errors. Oh, wait, I'm already up to 3 errors. Wait, what's the third error? When did the third error 3 come up? Okay, so. Let's do our rounds. Autopilot looks like it's working. Hydraulic A is at 21% and dropping. All that looks good. Fuel looks good. I don't think there's any errors there. No, there. Hydraulics, we already know about that. That's good. So we're good. Okay. Don't know what the other error is. It's probably not an issue that would matter to the plane. Let's have another drink.
Climb and maintain flight level 240 flare 501.
Okay, I guess I am kind of curious. What is that other error message? Or failure? Navigation, ADF L fail. Okay, ADF L.
Pasco tree 003.
What's ADF L? That would be, Don't know what that means.
Keep speed not above 220 knots. Pasco tree 003.
But everything looks like it's working just fine, so. What that means, because it looks like everything's working.
Going to 126.525 Pasco Tree 003.
I'm guessing with a hydraulic leak, I'm sure normally would be landing. But we're gonna keep going until we can't go anymore. Maybe I should switch to autopilot B. Since autopilot A will fail. No, we'll wait till it fails. We have to test this scientifically, so we'll wait until it fails.
Edmonton Center BB Seal Clubber 69er yep, heavy flight level 330.
Also clouds at this altitude. Percent for hydraulics and a side. It's plenty. That's plenty. And autopilot's still engaged, so there's that. Should have had a fourth a. Oh no, I guess not. Eight percent hydraulic fluid. It's fine. It's perfectly acceptable. Uh-oh. Flight controls. Oh, autopilot. A has failed, so let's go to autopilot B. Can't tell. There we go. So autopilot B has taken over. So we're good. No auto land. Well, wait. Flight controls. Then it's not necessary. So fuel pressure is down to 80 psi. I'm assuming that's psi. So hydraulic A has failed. So let's go ahead and turn that off. Feel different pressure. I don't know what that means. Wasn't there like an alternate or something? So some of the spoilers aren't gonna work. That's failed. It's fine. Plane's still controlling itself. Autopilot's still running. No auto land, but I'm probably not gonna use that anyways. So both fuel pressure gauge or fuel pumps are off on A. Isn't there like an alternate? Standby rudder. Okay, well, I don't know what I'm supposed to do, so. I'm just gonna flip this because I'm gonna assume that standby means yes. Yeah, why not? That should be fine. Okay, what else do I need to do? Let's see. That's fine. That's all fine. that's fine. That's fine. Oh, game's frozen again. Wait a minute. Should that say... You know what? I don't know. I don't know. Plane's still doing what it's supposed to be doing. So that's fine. Let's see what the errors are. So we got ADF L failure, you know, EMD, hydraulic leak, fail, hydraulic fail. That's fine. That's perfectly acceptable.
United 59 or climb and maintain flight level 420.
We still have 2% of pressure in there. Can we make that, or 2%, not pressure, but just 2%. Can we just say fuck it? Two percent, I guess, is not good enough. I guess we'll just murder the pumps. Okay, I guess I'll leave it off. Wait a minute, something just happened.
United 5-9 are climb and maintain flight level
14. Oh, turbulence. That's okay. Maybe that was just turbulence. So my flaps don't work? Does that mean that... Will those still work? Okay. We'll be fine. We will continue on as if nothing has happened. Oh, I forgot to charge the battery in my iPad, so iPad power is probably gonna die soon. Oh well. Look, just turn it off. Ooh, 10%. I don't think I'll need my charts anyways. I'm gonna go charge my iPad. Something tells me charts won't be
that. 133.45 for BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy. Edmonton Center BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy flight level 330.
Low hydraulic
pressure.
You got it.
Good day.
132.8 BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy. Winnipeg Center BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy flight level 330.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy Winnipeg Center. Continue to day pop as planned.
Figure out why my damn iPad, my surface won't restart. like I'll be buying a laptop or something to replace it. Probably a laptop. Because as much as I like Surfaces, the amount I use it for is kind of slim, so I think maybe a laptop would be better. Something portable. Uh-oh. Why is there flashing caution light? There's now six errors. Uh-oh. What's that? Doors. What's wrong with my doors? Forward service. I'm not losing cabin pressure. Cabin pressure is stable. We're at whatever, I guess 6,000 feet. Or 68, whatever. It's not going up or down, so I think we're good. I think we're fine. Not gonna worry about that. That's just who cares. Let's see what this actually says. So, smoke detector. What's SUPN smoke detector? I'm not sure which one that is. And then door one right. So it looks like the front right door is failed in some way. You know what? Looks fine. Cabin pressure is good. We haven't lost cabin pressure, so. I think we'll leave it be. Yep, we'll leave it be. I mean, even if we lost pressure, we're still gonna leave it be. Because passengers can become cargo too. Alright, while we're waiting, let's see what my fuel is like gonna be. 5.9, wow, so I gained fuel. Or I gained fuel there, whatever. So we're good.
and maintain flight level 380.
Still got six errors. Okay. The spoilers still work, obviously, but I guess. Let's see. So some of the slats are not working. I think it said the inboard, no. Is it the inboard slats or the outboard slats? It said. Inboard flight spoiler. Oh, so I'm not gonna have ground spoiler, so I think that's the brakes. I guess inboard flight spoiler. Don't work. So I won't have nose wheel steering. No number one thrust reverser. PTU for auto slats. I don't know what that means. PTU. Ooh, methods for transfer of hydraulic fluid. With wheel chocks in place, oh, I guess this is only done on the ground. EMDPs. What the fuck is an EMDP? That's something I can fuck with? Probably not. I'm gonna guess not. You know, since we're gonna have shit fail anyways. Anti-ice. Left, right. Heaters. Auxiliary fuel transfer. And we're not doing fuel, so we don't have to worry about that. Oh, that's where I do the source. Shit. Okay. Display source. Control panels, both. Okay. That is fuel. Temperature? What about hydraulics? So I guess there's no way to, maybe there's not a way to do it. Oh well. Oh, I see error number 7. But sure. I guess this has to be done in the ground. Okay, you know what? That's fine. Whatever. Whatever. I guess there's no way to transfer hydraulics from one to the other. I guess it wouldn't be a good idea since it was leaking anyways. Although it would be kind of funny to do it. Let's see what kind of errors I've got now. I'm also actually gonna have a lot of fuel. You know what? I can go faster since I'm gonna have plenty of fuel to get there. I can go faster. 8-1. Alright, so while we're doing that, let's check our failures. 7. So we got main battery fail. Oh, that's. That's what the generators are for. Who gives a shit about the battery? We got like alternators and shit. That I don't know. Okay, so main battery fail. So that would be.
661 climb and maintain flight level tree 60.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. I'm not really sure what this means, but I think you know what? That's fine if the battery fails. That's fine. And obviously it's not affecting the plane, so gives a shot. Since the sun's on that side, let's do this like it actually does anything. Because it clearly does not. Alright, so we've got some time to see what's going on outside. Oh, now we're just to flat areas and crap. Come on, Canada? I thought there was hella mountains here. This area doesn't have mountains? Wait, I'm flying over Canada still, right? Still in Canada, okay. So I should be going that way soon. Why am I off? No, that's normal. Okay, well, whatever. ...800 nautical miles to the next waypoint, so another drink. So I think if the gears fail to go down, I think there's an auxiliary panel thingamajig here. Okay. That is not helpful at all. Yeah, see, there we go. Alt extension door. So I just pull these and the gear will come out. So we're good. So we can't lower the gear, so that'll be fine. Okay.
124 decimal tree BB seal clubber 69er heavy. Winnipeg Center BB seal clubber 69er heavy flight level tree 0.
BB seal clubber 69er heavy Winnipeg Center, continue as planned.
Almost definitely continue as planned. And so far it's not been bad. I should do weather, shouldn't I? Let's quest winds and crap, because that will matter and stuff. Time today, buddy. Execute, yes. That means using reserve fuel. Yeah, you know what? Reserve these nuts. I already know it's ready. Alright, so that's good, I guess. Let's check our fuel. 6.9. We're still good. Unless you're crying about our fuel. What does that mean? Weird. Actually, you know what? Fuck it. Fuck it. Leave that be. I don't know what that means. Not a lot of radio traffic. Back over snow area again. This will be landing at night. Assuming we actually make it there. Uh-oh, TCAS fail. Well, that's not a flight ending flight problem. So that's okay. If TCAS fails, it just means that it doesn't matter. Yeah, TCAS fail. So let's see what the hell it just says. Battery, don't care. Smoke, whatever. Hydraulics, I don't need it. Transponder 1 fail. Okay. So, one of my transponders failed. Isn't there a backup? Boom. Transponder number 2, back online. Problem solved with a switch. Okay, so we fixed that. We still have 0.2% hydraulic fluid and no pressure in hydraulics A, but we have B. So that's good enough. Only some of my shit works. Not necessary. That was an easy fix. On to the next failure. I feel these failures aren't coming on in exactly 10 minutes, but that's okay. Engines look like they're doing good, so we're fine. Subject to that. Damn, I still have a long way to go. 700 nautical miles and 166, then 40, 35, 26. And then my top of descent crap.
Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy contact Winnipeg Center on 132 decimal niner.
But what if I don't want to?
132 decimal niner BP Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy. Winnipeg Center BP Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy flight level 330.
BP Seal Clubber 6-9er heavy Winnipeg Center, continue as planned.
Delta 295, contact Winnipeg Center on 124 decimal tree. Good day. Going to 124 decimal tree, Delta 295.
Add some coke to my alcohol.
Level 300. Delta 187, descend and maintain flight level 340.
That's what I'm not talking about. Well, it's gonna get dark soon. Oh, the zoom feature's not working, but that's normal. These nuts. see.
Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy. Winnipeg Center BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy Flight Level 330.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy Winnipeg Center. Continue as planned.
Dookie.
127.6 BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy. Minneapolis Center BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy Flight Level 330.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy Minneapolis Center. Continue as planned.
What's the error now? Doors again. Doors again. So that's probably another door failure somewhere. forward entry door.
Oh no!
Both. Oh, forward service. Camera pressure is still holding stable. So, I'm not gonna worry about it. Not going to worry about it. I guess I'll check the fuel levels. Let's see. 6.5. It's excellent. Oh, that's normal. That's normal. Center tanks are dry. That's perfectly acceptable. Another minute, should have another failure.
Decimal 2 for BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy. Minneapolis Center BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy Flight Level 330.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy Minneapolis Center. Continue as planned.
Ooh, 10 failures. I don't know what the 10th failure is. Let's see. Autopilot appears to be working. Oh my god, I'm having an engine fire. Here we go. I mean, nothing's going on. Nothing's going on at all. That red light means nothing. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about that red line. That means nothing. See, everything's fine. Everything's fine. It's fine. See, it's going back down. It's like explosive diarrhea. See, it's like it's having explosive diarrhea. It's perfectly acceptable. It gets a little hot when you have hot sauce, and then you poop it out, and it burns a little bit, but it's okay because it goes away after a while. So that red line there, it's fine. It's perfectly fine. See, it's cooling down. Whatever. Fire's cool, yo. Fire, yo. I may have a fire. I'm gonna shut down engine number one. My transponder seems to have also failed because science. Transponder. Transponder's working, you ask, right? 6665, yeah.
It's 6665.
Okay, so I just lost number one engine. I can't keep my speed, so I gotta decrease my altitude.
Minneapolis Center BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy.
Oh, yes.
Request flight level 230.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy descend and maintain flight level 270. Expect flight level 230.
I can't maintain my speed, so I'm dropping altitude.
Descend and maintain flight level 270. Expect flight level 230 BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy.
Okay, engine one is offline. Let's see, generator one off. That's gonna be off. What else do I need to turn off when I have an engine fire? Oh, that reminds me. Did the okay? So the left auto discharge. Temperature's dropping, so the fire's out, I'm assuming. That's fine. So now we gotta go to FMC, we gotta do engine out. Left engine out. Max altitude, 13,000 feet. Okay, well that's... That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. We're doing good. So, yeah. Engine fires out. So we're still gonna go to 230 anyways.
Descend and maintain flight level 230 BD Seal Clubber 69er heavy.
We can't maintain our speed either, it looks like. So target speed 259 looks, I guess that's what that means. Target speed 259. Oops.
Bravo speed.
So we'll slow to 259. 259, whatever. Well, apparently auto throttle doesn't work when you have an engine out. So I guess manual it is. I just manually adjust the throttles. Wait a minute. Why is my throttle not? Oh, auto throttle is working again. Weird. Okay, auto throttle is working again. That's weird. Nope, now auto throttle is not working again. There you go. Okay, auto throttle's back up again. Okay, weird. Nope, auto throttle's off again. Okay, well, manual throttle it is. We're having trouble keeping that speed up, aren't we? 250. Okay, we're doing fine. Yeah, we're doing fine. Oh, some of the autopilot crap's not working. Altitude? Oh, that's working. No, that's not working either. I have no idea why I pushed that button. Huh. I'm having trouble with autopilot here. What's our errors look like? So main battery fail, yeah, we know that. Engine 1 EGT exceedance, yeah, that's called fire. Engine 1 bottle 1 squib left, yep, because I discharged it. We knew that. Doors left and one right. Okay. So that's fine.
jet 735 climb and maintain flight level 420. Navy SEAL Clubber 6-9er heavy contact, Minneapolis Center on 134.75. Good day.
Yeah.
134.75 BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy.
So we had one engine fail, so that's okay. We do have the other engine.
Minneapolis Center BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy flight level 230.
So
I'm going to turn on APU just in case. Alright, so no auto throttle. For some reason, altitude is not. I don't know what's going on with my altitude here, but. It's holding steady, so that's okay. So, yeah, we're good. We're doing good. Obviously, they would be flying, they would be landing now after the autopilot, or after the engine failure, but I'm not going to do that. Also, what the hell is XB? I don't know why auto throttle's not working. Not sure why. Oh, maybe because the engine failed? Maybe because the engine failed. Oh, yeah, you know why? Because the engine failed. Yeah, that makes sense. And because I have this throttle. Yeah, I think I know what's going on. Okay. That's fine.
Some of the
Okay, I'm going there. Up to 32,000 feet. Let's see, where the fuck am I? Yeah, I'm just gonna land there. Emergency landing. So fuck ATC. I'm just gonna land there. Fuck it. I'm abandoning the in fact, you know, I'm gonna just do I'm ignoring ATC. I'm gonna do an emergency landing.
And maintain flight level 230 BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy.
Let's see. W-I-R-S-A. What the fuck? W-I-R-S-A. RW. So it's going to be RW. When I send it, I'll be running on 27.
BB Seal Clubber 69er, Eddie, please expedite your climb flight level 230.
No. Son of a bitch. Some of it should have been all over again.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, contact Minneapolis Center on 127.9er. Good day.
OMDOE.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, acknowledged. Last transmission. 127.9er BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy. Minneapolis Center BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy is passing flight level 195, climbing flight level 230.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, Minneapolis Center. Continue to Golf Romeo Bravo as planned. BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, contact Minneapolis Center on 121.05. Good day.
...6,000 nautical miles? So it's none of these. So how do I tell it to...
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, did you hear my last transmission?
...121.05 BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy. Minneapolis Center BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy is passing flight level 185, climbing flight level 230.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy, Minneapolis Center altimeter 29.87, continue to Golf Romeo Bravo as planned.
Minneapolis Center BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy would like to cancel IFR.
BB Seal Clubber 69er Heavy IFR flight plan is canceled, radar service terminated. approach via Hotel India Bravo transition.
2986.
Clear to Hotel India Bravo. SkyWest 4236, descend and maintain 3,500 feet. Descend and maintain 3,500.
Duluth Tower BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy is 15 miles southwest 16,300 feet with Gulf to land.
BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy Duluth Tower. Altimeter 29.87 wind 184 at 6. Enter left traffic runway 27.
Fly left traffic runway 27 BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy.
Drop to, let's say, 5,000 feet. I think to be at 32, so let's say 4,000 feet. T73, of course. T73, you can see. I need to be at 1087. I don't know why I just did that. 1087. I just raised social defenses because I get minimums 18,000. $18,60 for minimums. I'm gonna do some speed brake to slow the fuck down, because I need to get to 4,000 feet. Okay, I'm gonna do auto brake to 2. Menu. Not menu, reference. Approach. Lights on. I see nothing. Should probably not do flashing lights. Oh yeah, using reserve fuel. Still flashing. Okay. Well, this is gonna be a mess. Alarm's not gonna work, obviously, but I'm gonna use the... Oh! I should also do this, too. Runway length is gonna be... Why is that so different? 5719. Goes. Goes. All right. We're descending to 3,200 feet.
Bravo.
BS 2500.
I'm gonna go to flaps 2. Flaps 5. Okay, flaps 10.
Airspeed low.
Gear down.
Airspeed low.
gear's not coming down. The gear's not coming down. Okay. I guess I gotta do the manual thing. Gears, please come down.
Airspeed low. Airspeed low.
Class 15. I'm not sure what's complaining now. Complaining now. Okay, that's why. I'm not sure what that means. Flaps 40. It's not gonna work. Okay, I'm gonna go flaps 40 or flap 30. I'm still high. Can't even see the damn runway. This may not be a successful landing. I think I'm too far to the right. I'm still too far to the right. Now.
1,000.
Bullshit. How to turn because I have no rudder controls. How do I So if you have no rudder controls, how do you, oh wait, you know what? Oh, there it goes. Figured it out.
Taxiway Delta Bravo cross runway tree Bravo BB Seal Clubber 6-9er Heavy.
The auto brakes are off. Flight directors, all the other crap is off. That landing was kind of bullshit, but at least I figured out how to do nose wheel steering, the alternate nose wheel steering. No. Go ahead and do APU generators. Uh-oh. Why didn't the... How come my APU... Does my APU generator not work? Yeah, well. Well, screw it, turning off IRS and made a crap anyways, it doesn't... like we need it. I don't know why. Interesting. I don't know why that other stuff turned off. Did my APU fail? My APU never turned on, that's why. Oh, there it goes. Now it's running. It never turned on. Could have swore I turned it on in flight. Must have not turned it on during flight then. Okay, APU power. The fuck? Okay, something is murdering the APU. Okay. Figure that out when we get to the stop. Parking brake powers activate. I don't need that crap. Okay, I'm gonna shut down both engines, well, the other engine. APU fault. Well, that would explain. That would explain a lot.
BB Seal Clubber 69 okay. Or Heavy, could you please connect the jetway to the aircraft?
BB Seal Clubber 69 or Heavy.
Alright, well, before more fun connected. Stuff happens, let's see what errors I actually had. Failures, 19 failures. Alright, so generator 1. Okay, battery, aux battery. So both batteries failed. That's the engine fire, engine oil temperature, engine 1 vibration, bottle 1 squid, fire bottle discharge, I don't know what this is, soup smoke detector, Engine 1 hydraulic failure. A hydraulic failure. ILS, R fail, ADF, L fail, left failure. Transponder 1 failure. Train radar. RMI, I don't remember what that is. Doors, one left and one right failed. Very nice. Well, that was fun. That was most definitely fun. Alright. That was fun. 2 hours. And it didn't crash. Very nice.